come to New York, thanks to Roman, who developed scarlet fever prior to the first departure. Finally, 3 years later, on May the 4th, 1950, Roman and his younger brother Eugene, along with their parents, arrived in New York City and settled in the East Village. Two sisters, Helen and Mary, were born shortly afterwards, and like all the other immigrant Ukrainians, the family joined at St. George Parish and sent their children to St. George Elementary School. Thinking of a priestly vocation, Roman packed his belongings and started high school at St. Basil's Preparatory School in Stamford, Connecticut. He prayed, learned, joined sports, and created friendships in his new seminary life. However, that ended when he was asked to leave at the end of his sophomore year. Roman finished high school at LaSalle Academy in Manhattan. The next big step, the City College of New York, was abandoned due to a lack of scholarly ambition, and Roman opted to join in the Vietnam War. He enlisted into the Marine Corps, giving his parents 2 weeks' notice of this momentous decision. God looked with favor on Roman as he spent the bulk of the war in the communications center, transporting sensitive documents in Southeast Asia. In 1970, he was honorably discharged with the rank of sergeant, and he came back to New York with aspirations to finish his college education while he worked downtown for an insurance company. During that time, he met Irene, married, began a family, and graduated from St. John's University School of Law. With his Doctor of Jurisprudence degree in hand, a wife and 2 sons, Roman took another significant step in his life. He, along with his partner, Alfred Will, opened the firm of Badiak and Will on 120 Broadway in downtown Manhattan. This firm grew to 10 attorneys working in unison and in camaraderie many, many years, with Roman handling the administrative portion of the practice. As a fun-loving boss, he could be heard singing Christmas carols during the hot, humid days of summer. That was Roman, full of unpredictability. The last part of Roman's life began when he started questioning his future. What was the purpose of his existence? Was there something missing in his life? Was there a need to begin a new venture? These moments of doubt and wonder were answered one Sunday at the annual Connecticut Day Festival in Stamford, when Roman met with Bishop Basil Boston. After this discussion, Roman started attending St. Basil College on a part-time basis. In 2007, Roman retired from the practice of law and entered Holy Apostles Seminary in Cromwell, Connecticut, on a full-time basis, graduating with a Master of Divinity degree in 2009. Roman was ordained to the priesthood on May 2, 2010, by Bishop Paul Kominski, and began his priestly service as an assistant pastor in Yonkers, New York. There were 2 major parish assignments in his pastoral life. Roman was asked to take over a small parish in Peterborough, England. St. August Parish had approximately 30 parishioners who rarely attended Sunday services. During Roman's tenure there, the number of parishioners increased to almost 100 parishioners, who to this day recall all his accomplishments and their love of him. He was truly a shepherd who watched over his sheep. Father Roman's next major assignment was in St. Petersburg, Florida. During that time, a church choir was organized, and to this day has flourished and added to the enhancement of all church services. People found Father Roman to be a great listener and a compassionate advisor. One young parishioner wrote, Father, did I know I was meeting one of the influential people in the life of my family. Not only have you been a mentor, helping me out of dark places and showing me compassion, you baptized my mother and my sister, which was a miracle, as I never saw the conversion of my family happening. You saved their souls and have been a true spiritual father to us. When we look back at Father Roman's life, which had so many twists and unexpected turns, we have to wonder if this was God's plan all along. We consider that he left us too soon, and we wish he could have spent more time with us while on this earth. But who are we to question? Let us never forget this famous proverb: man proposes, but God disposes.